On us another opportunity, Lord, just to come into this house, Lord, and to feel your presence, and God be with you tonight. Father, I pray for this service. I pray every song we sing, every word we speak will bring glory and honor and praise to you. God, I pray for your freedom and your liberty in this house. God, let your will be accomplished in this service. God, we pray it all tonight in the name of Jesus. And everyone said,
Amen.
Amen. Let's worship the Lord tonight.
How many are happy they're washed in the blood?
Amen.
Amen.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed
in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb, of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you walking daily by the Savior's side? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Do you rest each moment in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood, in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb, of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? When the bridegroom cometh, will your robes be white, pure and white in the blood of the Lamb? Will your souls be ready for the mansion's bright and be washed in the blood of the Lamb? Blood in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb, of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Oh, are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow?
Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
How many are thankful tonight that all your hope rests in Jesus?
Amen.
Yeah, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
I've been held by the Savior.
I've been freed and forgiven, and I'm not going back. I'll never be the same. That's why I sing, all my hope is in Jesus. There's a kind of thing that just breaks a man, breaks him down to his knees. God, I've been broken more than a time or two. Yes, Lord, then he picked me up and showed me what it means to be a man. Come on and sing, all my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone, and all my sins are forgiven.
This love that won't relent, that's calling out with heaven's breath, who's rich and wide to save our souls, only you. What is this grace that makes no sense, that we could never recompense? Gives us all a second chance. Only you, only you, only you.
Oh, there is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. There is no other God who can save. There is no one like our God.
Who hung the stars upon the night and showed the sun how bright to shine? Who shaped the world within His hand? Only you. Who set the skies upon the hills and told the waters to be still? Born the universe, only you. Only
There's no other God who can save. There is no one like our God.
No,
there is no one like our God. There is no other God who can save. There is no one like our God.
No life nor death can stand between us. No power on earth or all creation. No life or death can separate us from your love.
Oh, no height or depth can stand between us. No power on earth or all creation. No life or death can separate us from your love.
Sing that again. No height.
No height or depth can stand between us. No power on earth or all creation. No life or death can separate us from your love.
Oh, there is no one like our God.
There is no one like our God. There is no other God who can save.
Search for all eternity long and find there is none like you.
Do you believe that tonight? Lift your hands and sing it again.
There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you.
Lord, there is none like you.
No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you.
I could search, oh,
I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you.
Hallelujah. Can you give the Lord a hand clap of praise tonight? Hallelujah. If you have a need this evening, we're going to take those before the Lord. If you'd let us know by just lifting your hands, we're going to pray. Father, we love you. God, we thank you first and foremost that you have met us here tonight, God, that we can come in and you're already here. Your Spirit is already here and moving in this place tonight, Lord. God, you know every need that's represented here. Lord, we just bring them up to you. We place them at your feet. And Lord, by faith, we just say, Lord, have your way.
Yes.
God, we can't do anything with our hands, with our might, with our power. But God, by our faith in you, Lord, we know that you can make a way.
Yes.
Lord, would you make a way this evening where there seems to be no way? Jesus, we love you. We thank you for everything you do for us. And everybody said, amen. Thank you.
mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
You have been so good.
the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes the devil tries to steal our song. He tries to make us feel like it ain't worth it. He tries to get our eyes on our problems and our situations that life has put us in right here at this moment. But I like what that song says, with every breath that I am able, I'm going to sing of the goodness of God. You may knock me down, devil, but you haven't knocked me out. I'm going to lift my voice and I'm going to sing of the goodness of God. You will not get the upper hand on me. Amen. Because my God has been faithful and He has been so, so good. Even in my darkest hour, He's been there. Can we sing it again tonight? You feel like you ain't got a song? Muster it up and just begin to think about how good and wonderful your God is. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, my life, you have been faithful. Oh, my life, you have been so, so
tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Am I not worthy of thy worship? Am I not worthy of thy praise? I have brought thee out of darkness into my marvelous light. I am the Lord thy God, and I am with thee this night, my children. I walk with thee. I talk with thee. I am the Lord thy God, and I am with thee this night, my children. I say unto thee, lift me up, and I will draw you unto me. For I am with thee this night, my people, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, lift him up tonight. You want him close in your life tonight? Lift him up and begin to worship him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we honor you. We recognize you, God, and we say tonight we need you right here in this place. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. See, Satan knows if he can steal our praise, he can steal our joy. And doesn't the Bible say the Lord inhabits the praises of his people? So if you want God to do something in your life, begin to praise Him and let Him come and show up in the midst of your situation. Amen. Hallelujah. Give Him one more hand clap of praise tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
If you have your Bibles tonight, you may be seated. I'd like you to turn to 1 Peter chapter 5, and we're going to read verse number 8. And while you're turning there, I believe Sister Beth has a testimony. Didn't you say you wanted to testify tonight? I got a text message from Billy before service. I put on the prayer line to pray that he was having a CAT scan. He was losing blood, and they couldn't figure out where it was. But he got good news from the CAT scan. They said it's from a hematoma from where he had the wreck, and the blood was going to that bruise, that bad bruise that he had. So he's not losing any blood anywhere. It's just going to that bruise. So he got good results from that. I got to pray with him in the hospital, and he gave his heart back to the Lord. So just pray that he gets back where he needs to be with the Lord and the God, which God has shown himself to him. So just continue to remember him tonight. So let's stand, if you can, for the reading of the Word, if you're able, and you like to. It says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Tonight I want to preach on the thought of leave me alone, Satan. Leave me alone, Satan. Let's pray. Father, I thank you, Lord, for your presence. God, I thank you for the testimonies on, God, how you've answered prayer here in this place tonight. God, I thank you, Lord, because you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And God, you never change. God, I pray tonight, God, as I deliver this message, God, that I might say, God, the words that you want spoken here tonight, and help me not to say what I want to say, but God, help me to say what the Holy Ghost would have me to say here in this place. God, anoint every ear to hear, and God, every heart to receive. And Father, I pray all this tonight in the name of Jesus. And everyone said, amen. Leave me alone, Satan. How many knows we have an adversary tonight? I didn't come to lift up the devil. I didn't come to give glory and honor to the devil. But can I tell you tonight, he's not a figment of our imagination. He's real, and he's doing a good job at what he does. He's like a roaring lion seeking who may devour. Amen. He wants to devour each and every one of us sitting here tonight. As long as you have breath in your body, he's going to do everything he can to rain havoc in your life and try to disrupt your life and try to devour you and to pull you away from God. He doesn't like it. You made an effort to be here tonight, but we need to get sick and tired of the devil and tell him, amen, to leave me alone in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm a blood-bought child of the Most High God, and my God and my Father takes care of his children. Amen. Now, Satan doesn't quit. He doesn't give up. He keeps coming and he keeps coming and he keeps trying to do everything he can to disrupt and to devour as many as he can. That's why the Word of God tells us that we must remain sober and vigilant, because our adversary, the devil, is as a roaring lion walking around seeking whom he may devour. I hate to tell you this, but we can look around tonight and see or think about people that used to sit in these pews that no longer darken a church door anywhere. They've been devoured by the enemy. They've been devoured by old slewfoot Satan. Amen. They listen to the lie of the enemy. Or maybe their minds got clouded. Or maybe other things got more important. Or maybe something happened. Somebody said something that caused them to be hurt, and they no longer come to the house of God, and they've been devoured by the enemy of their soul. Amen. I don't know about you, but this hurts me as a pastor, and we ought to hurt as we see our brothers and sisters that once used to serve God that no longer serve God. They've allowed the enemy of their soul to devour them. Maybe we got loved ones, family members, children, grandparents, or maybe even a spouse that have been devoured by the enemy of their soul. Amen. I'm tired of the devil tonight. I'm tired of him walking into God's house and taking children that don't belong to him. Leave me alone, Satan. Leave me alone. Amen. But sometimes I think we get numb to the fact and we think, well, maybe they should have known better. Just let them be. How many knows tonight we need to be concerned about the devoured? We need to pray for those that no longer come to the house of God. Amen. We need to be willing to stand in the gap and make up the hedge. Amen. For those that are missing from the body of Christ. Amen. People are missing. People are hurting tonight. And we as God's people need to take a stand and tell the devil you're not going to devour them and you're not going to drag them to hell. I'm going to stand in the gap. I'm going to make up the hedge. And I'm going to bombard heaven and I'm going to throw them a lifeline. I'm going to reach out and tell them I still love them. I'm going to reach out and say, it's all right, God still loves you. Amen. And God still cares about you. So many times when people start missing church or they start getting away from God, we just let them go. But we need to bombard heaven and say, devil, you're not going to take them. You're not going to destroy them. But I'm going to stand in the gap and I'm going to make up the hedge for them. I don't know about you, but I wouldn't be standing here tonight if somebody didn't stand in the gap and make up the hedge for me. I would be dead or in hell tonight if somebody wasn't willing to stand in the gap and say, get your hands off my son, or get your hands off my brother or my sister. Amen. Whoever, amen, they might be. Amen. I wish I could get it out like I feel it. But we need to bombard heaven and reach out to them. And let them know they're still valuable to God. Amen. But the Word of God tells us to stay sober. Amen. So we are not devoured. Amen. I've seen people I thought would never give up on God have given up on God. I've seen people that have been in church most of their lives walk out of church and never walk back again. Amen. Because they got their mind, amen, sidetracked. They got their mind, amen, clouded up with other things. And other things begin to get more important than God. I've seen people do ministry, amen, and lose out on God because they got their eyes on their ministry and they got their eyes off God. Amen. As Brother Helton preached this morning, it's got to be all about Jesus and our relationship with Jesus Christ. Because if we neglect our relationship with Jesus Christ, how many knows the enemy of our soul will sneak in and devour us? But we must remain sober, amen, and that we are not devoured. Don't think you're so holy and so spiritual that the enemy can never devour you. Amen. But we must keep our minds focused on God. Keep our minds clear and unclouded from the things of this world. You can watch the news and look around and get sad, depressed, and discouraged. But we need to know that God is still in control and God still has a plan. And this world is not my home. Amen. I got a home waiting on me in heaven. If I stay sober. If I stay vigilant, that means quit drinking. Yeah, you ought to quit drinking. But we need to keep our minds sober. Amen? Keep your mind fixed on the Lord. Don't let the enemy come in and cloud up your mind. We can get so concerned just about life. And life problems, life situations, and just busy with life. And our minds get so focused and clouded that we get our minds off the Lord, and then the enemy of our soul can sneak right in and devour us. Amen. And the Word of God tells us to remain vigilant. The word vigilant means keeping careful watch for possible danger or difficulties. Amen. How can we keep watch if our minds are clouded? How many knows when your mind's not clouded, you're not seeing like you should? Your mind gets cloudy and you're not as focused is what you should be, but we should stay focused on God, focused on God's plan that He has for our life, focused on the Word of God, amen, that we may remain vigilant for the Lord, amen, that we do not become Satan's next victim, amen. We cannot let down. We must remain steadfast and immovable in the things of God. It's not time to see how much less we can pray and still be saved. But we ought to stay, I want to pray as much as I can pray so I can stay saved. But so many times we get busy with life and prayer. Our prayer life begins to deteriorate. And then our minds get cloudy. And then the enemy of our soul runs in and he attacks. How many knows he don't come with a red suit and a pitchfork? I've said this before. He sets off to the side and he waits until your mind gets so troubled and so fixed on your problem, or your mind gets so clouded with everything else, or you get distracted. And that's when he runs in. Amen? But we must remain vigilant. We must be watching and ready so when the enemy does come, because he will come, you're not exempt from the attack of the enemy tonight. Amen. I'm not here to paint you some phony picture. You come to Jesus and you're never going to have a problem again. You're never going to have to fight against the enemy again. You're never going to have any troubles in your life. That's not true. Amen, but I come to tell you the truth tonight. Amen, that God is greater than every devil in hell that comes against us. Amen, and God, amen, is the Bible says that greater is He that is in us than he that's in the world. Amen, but he that's in the world wants to devour and destroy us by getting our minds so clouded up with everything else that we lose sight and lose focus of the Lord. Amen. We must remain vigilant in prayer, vigilant in the Word, vigilant in church, amen, vigilant in the house of God, amen. And we must keep our hearts and minds fixed on the Lord, amen. Satan is doing everything he can to get us sidetracked, deterred, and busy so we can't do one of those things. How many knows when you quit praying, then you quit reading, and then you quit coming to church? And how many knows when you quit one of those things, it's hard to get started again? Amen. Just being real, I haven't prayed like I should before. And I had to get myself back in that routine. I didn't go to church like I was supposed to for a while. I had to get myself back in that we say routine, but I got to the point where I didn't even care if I went to church. I lost my desire for church. But I had to pray and say, Lord, rekindle that fire. Rekindle that desire. Lord, I get excited about coming to the house of God. I get excited about being in the presence of Almighty God. Because the Word of God says where two of us would come together in His name, He'd be in the midst. So He's here with us tonight. I get excited about being with Him, don't you? But when we lose that excitement and we lose that joy of spending time with Him in prayer and in the Word and in His house, the enemy can sneak in and attack. Amen? And next, be careful who you listen to and who you watch. Amen? Not everything that says it's Christian is always of God. Not everything that comes on Christian TV or Christian radio is of God. Matthew 24, verse 24 says, "For there shall arise false Christs, false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible that they shall deceive the very elect." We're living a day and hour, amen, we have so many different false teachings, false doctrines, amen, and some of them are just very, very, just a little off. And they'll tell you there's another way to get to heaven. You do good, don't hurt nobody, work hard, take care of your family, live a good life. You don't need Jesus. You can do it on your own. How many knows that's a lie from the pit of hell? There's only one way to heaven. That's through Jesus Christ, right? He's the way, the truth, and the life, and there is no other way. But we have so many different doctrines that are just a little bit off, or they leave out a few scriptures. And we need to be sober. We need to be vigilant. We need to be in the Word of God. So when we hear things and we see things, we need to know if it doesn't line up with the Word of God, tell it to get up. You know, just don't let it come into your mind anymore. Turn it off, or don't watch it anymore. Amen? Because it says the very elect could be possibly deceived. That's why it's so important to know the Word of God. This isn't just a coffee table decorator. This is our lifeline, right? But anyway, we need to use the Word. Not just know the Word, but we need to be able to use the Word. Turn over to Matthew chapter 4 with me. And we're going to read verses 1 through 11. Just be careful who you listen to and what you watch. Make sure it lines up with the Word of God. This is why we got to know what the Word of God says. Amen. And we need to try the spirits. If it doesn't feel right, maybe it ain't right. Amen. But we need to be able to use the Word of God. Matthew 4, verses 1 through 11. Then was Jesus led of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hungered. And when the tempter came to him, he said, If thou be the Son of God, command these stones be made to bread. But he answered and said, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Then the devil taketh him up. See, he never quits. He keeps coming. This is Jesus. He's a dummy. He ought to think, man, there ain't no way he's going to be able to tempt Jesus. But guess what? He keeps coming. He don't quit. Then the devil taketh him up into a holy city, setteth him on a pinnacle of the temple, and saith unto him, If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down, for it is written, He shall give his angels charge concerning thee in their hands, and they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Jesus said unto him, Again, it is written, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord God. Again, the devil taketh him. See, he's not giving up. He's coming again. Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord. Lost my place. Again, the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain. He showeth him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them. And he saith unto him, All these things will I give thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me. Then saith Jesus unto him, Get thee hence, Satan, or leave me alone, Satan. For it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him alone shalt thou serve. And I like what verse 4, Then the devil leaveth him, and behold, the angels came and ministered unto him. Amen. Jesus, our perfect example. Amen. The Bible says, was led of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. If Jesus, our perfect example, was tempted of the devil, why in the world do we think we're exempt? Huh? Why do we sing the blues when we're tempted or have trouble from the devil? Oh me. Oh my. Why is this happening to me? Like it's some strange thing that's going on. Why is the devil always picking on me? My, my. Poor me. Poor me. Poor me. How many knows we ought to be expecting to be picked on by the devil? As long as we try to serve God, as strong as we try to live for God, He's going to do everything in His power, amen, and His ability to try to tempt us and to pull us away from God. Amen? But we need to know tonight, I will be tempted. I will go through trials. I will go through tests in my life. I said go through. Just because you're tempted and just because you have a trial don't mean you have to give up. you can get through it because Jesus said, or the Word of God says, amen, that He is a very present help in the time of our trouble. He also said, I'll be your refuge and your strength. I will be there to give you the strength you need to go through the trial, the test, the temptation that you have to go through. But how many knows tonight? Sometimes we feel like He leaves. Just being real. How many has ever felt like God's left you? But we need to know what the Word of God said. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So how many knows Jesus is not a liar? So when you feel like He's gone, He's not there, you need to know what the Word of God says and know that He's still there. I may not feel Him, I may not see Him, but I need to know that I know. Brother Rick said it this morning, we need to know it down in our knower that He's still there. Amen. I can't see Him or feel Him, but I know He's there. Amen. Let's go on. We know that. Well, you don't have to read more scripture, but I just want to talk about these scriptures. But the first thing that Satan came to Jesus with, what did he tempt him with? An area that he was weak. How many know Satan knows your weaknesses? A lot of times we tell him our weaknesses. But the Bible says Jesus had just fasted for 40 days. So how many knows he was man? He wasn't God then, he was man. He was like us. So he had to be hungry. Didn't he? 40 days without food? You tell me you ain't hungry. 40 days without food. Here comes the devil. Take these stones, turn them to bread. What'd he do? Tempt him where he's weak. How many knows the devil don't play fair? He'll hit you where it hurts. He'll hit you in your finances. He'll hit you in your marriage. He'll hit you in your family. He'll hit you, amen, to your loved ones that are close to you. He'll cause people you thought were your friends to talk about you and rip your heart out. He knows, amen, our weaknesses, and He will hit us in our weak spots. Amen? Just me? He tries to get us, amen, where we're weak. He tries to get us, amen, where it hurts. He tries to hit us, amen, in our weakest places in our lives. But we must be like the Lord and use the Word of God against Him. Jesus was weak. Physically, He was weak. He was hungry. And it would have been so easy for Him to turn that stone into bread. And He didn't need the devil to tell Him to do it. But the devil was trying to tempt Him and trying to cause Him to, amen, to fall. But how many knows He did not fall? He stood on the Word of God. He used the Word of God, amen, and He did not give in to that temptation. Amen, there ain't no temptation that comes upon us that we have to give in to. Amen, because with every temptation that we have, there has to be a way of escape. But if we're going to escape our temptations, we got to use to learn the Word of God. Amen? All right. Satan knew Jesus was weak. He told him to turn those stones into bread. Jesus uses the Word against him. You want to tell Satan to get out of your life and leave you alone? Use the Word of God against him. Know the Word of God. Know what thus saith the Word of God. Know who you are in Christ Jesus. I'm a child of the Most High God. Amen? I'm the head and not the tail. Greater is He that is in me than he that is coming against me. Amen? No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Amen? And then what does Satan do next? He tries to get Jesus to prove Himself. He says, you know, if you're really the Son of God, if you're really a Christian, if you really are who you say, how many knows the devil tries to get us to prove ourselves? If you were really a child of God, you wouldn't be going through this mess that you're in. If you were really a child of God, would you have this sickness that you're having to deal with? If you were really the children of God, would you be having to go through what you're going through? And he tries to make us to have to prove ourselves that I am who I say I am. How many knows we don't have to prove ourselves to nobody except to God? Amen. Or Satan will try to make you feel like you're not good enough. Anybody ever been there? Oh, you've done too much. You're not never going to make heaven. Look at your life and look at their life. They're just so much better than you. They got everything. They were, you know, they got a good job. They got a good home. They got a good family. And look at you and look at what you don't have. How many knows we need to look inside our hearts and know I got Jesus? It don't matter if I got a nice home or a nice car. I got the Lord Jesus living in my heart. But he'll try to get us to try to prove ourselves. But we don't have to prove ourselves to nobody except for Him. Amen? You need to know who you are in Christ. If you're saved, you need to know you're saved. Amen? And it don't matter what Sister So-and-so thinks, or what Aaron thinks, or what Terry thinks, or what Sharon thinks. It matters what God thinks. Amen? We got to prove ourselves to Him. Doesn't it say live holy and acceptable, which is your reasonable service unto God? We're not to be living holy, amen, and righteous and spiritual to one another, but we're to live holy and righteous and spiritual to God. Amen. We are to prove ourselves to God. Amen. Not to anybody else. So he tries to tell Jesus, you know, prove who you are. Jesus didn't have to prove himself. So he uses the word on him again. And then what does he do? Satan, he promised to give him things he couldn't give him. You know, he said, come on up here and I'll give you all this stuff. How many knows it wasn't the devil's to give? God owns it all. But he'll make promises he cannot keep. Oh, you'll feel better if you do this. If you don't go to church so much, you'll have more time to get things done at home. If you just go with the flow, live like everybody else, accept everything, everybody will like you and you have all kinds of friends. He'll promise you things and tell you you'll be so much better just not coming to church, not tithing, not giving in the offering. You'll be have so much more money to do so many other things. Amen. He'll promise us a nice boyfriend or girlfriend. Amen. Outside of church. He'll promise this and he'll promise that. And how many knows he's a liar and the father of all lies? We need to tell him to leave me alone, Satan. Amen. I don't have to prove myself to you, and you can't make me no promises. Because everything you promised me is a lie. Amen. How many people have fallen into the trap of listening to the lie of the enemy? How many people have left their homes and went to another place? How many people have left churches and thought they'd be better off never coming to church again? I told you the story about a guy I used to work with. He had long hair. He came down to the altar to give his heart to the Lord. And the pastor came down off the pulpit and told him to get up, go get his hair cut, and then come back to church. He said, I'll never walk in a church door again. I hope today he has come back. That was many years ago. But he was deeply crushed and hurt. How many of those people will hurt you? But we need to know we're not in it for people. We're in it because we love the Lord. Amen. But anyway, let's go on. How many knows Jesus took authority over the devil? He tells him to get thee hence. That means go away or get out of here. Amen. He quotes the word. Don't tell the devil to get out of your way or get out of your life in your own power, in your own authority, in your own voice, in your own word. Amen. That you're me and you, we're no match for the enemy. It's God in us, and it's the Word of God, amen, that is powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword. You want to run the devil out of your home and out of your life? Use the Word of God, amen. Stand on the Word of God. Plead the blood of Jesus over your life and over your home, amen. And we need to run the devil off tonight, amen. But Jesus takes authority. He said, enough is enough. Amen. Get thee hence. Just go on your way. Leave me alone. Amen. We need to tell the devil, leave me alone tonight. Amen. I said this a minute ago, but I got a couple more scriptures. Remember tonight, his weapons that are formed against you will not prosper. Isaiah 54, verse 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. Every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is our heritage, the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. How many knows the Word of God doesn't say that some of Satan's weapons may knock you down? They may catch you off guard. I don't know about you, but I've been knocked down a time or two. Anybody else? It doesn't say those weapons may hurt. It doesn't say those weapons may sting. But it says those weapons that are formed shall not prosper. They may knock me to my knees, but I'm not knocked out. They may knock me back a few steps, but they're not going to cause me to give up on God. They may hurt for a while, but my God is still a healer, and God can come and rub salve on that hurt. We need to know tonight, no weapon formed against us shall prosper as long as we stay faithful to God. Don't expect to be a match for the enemy in your own power, your own strength, and your own wisdom, because he'll devour you. But if you'll stand in the power and the authority of the Word of God and Jesus Christ as Lord of your life, how many knows the devil has to flee in the name of Jesus? It is written tonight. In closing, as we stand to our feet and then return to the music, I want you to turn to Revelation 20, verse 10. If you have your Bible, if you haven't marked this in your Bible, mark it. If you mark in your Bible, mine's marked up, falling apart. This is my favorite Bible. I got other nice big Bibles in my office, but this is my favorite one. Got it all marked up, knows where things are. How many knows tonight we need to remind Satan of his future? Huh? Sometimes we just got to tell the devil what the Word of God says. Revelation 20, verse 10. Amen. The devil's been huffing and puffing in your life. He's been raining havoc in your life. How many know sometimes we just got to say, enough is enough, devil. Leave me alone. The Word of God says, Revelation 20, verse 10. This is his future. And the devil that deceived them, that old slew-foot devil that has deceived many that have devoured our brothers and sisters in Christ. Them and the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. How many knows there's coming an end to that old devil one day? Huh? And how many knows God's going to get the upper hand? We need to know what the Word of God says. The Word of God says it. How many knows it's going to come to pass? Amen. Maybe you're here tonight as we bow our heads and close our eyes. Maybe you've been going through some stuff. Maybe the enemy's been bugging you, bothering you, trying to torment you, trying to bring havoc in your life. Tonight, would you with me say, enough is enough. Satan, leave me alone. That's you tonight. I want to invite you to this altar. Take a step of faith and say, devil, you're not going to win. You're not going to get the upper hand in my life. I'm tired of listening to your lies. I'm tired of feeling the pain that I feel every day. I'm tired of the situations that I'm going through. And tonight, I'm going to make a step of faith. And I'm going to come to this altar. And I'm going to plead the blood of Jesus over my situation and in my life. That's you tonight. Would you come? The altars are open. That don't mean you're backslid away from God. It just means you're having to deal with some stuff. Maybe you're here tonight. You feel opposed by the enemy. Come. Say, God, I need you. Help me tonight. Help me to overcome the enemy. Help me to get victory over this thing. Help me to quit listening to the lies of the enemy. Help me to say enough is enough. That's you tonight. Would you come? Somebody else. The altars are open. Can I have some people come help pray for these? If you don't want to come to the front, right where we're at. Tell the devil enough is enough. Your day's coming, Slewfoot. You will be cast into that lake of fire. Amen. The altars are open. If you don't want to come to the front, let's all find us a place of prayer. Say, God, give me the strength to walk in victory over my enemy. Tonight, I'm something beautiful in the eyes of God. Amen. The devil likes to play that a lot today, but we need to know who we are. We are made and created by the Lord God Almighty. Can we sing that again tonight? Sing it to the devil. If you don't feel worthy or good enough tonight, you let him know I'm something beautiful in the eyes of God. Amen.
All I had to offer him.
Take the broken things of our lives and make us a whole lot better if we would be willing to submit it to Him. Amen. How many knows God ain't going to take your life and break it, make it, because of His force? It has to be us willing to give it. Can we have one more chorus before we dismiss? Amen.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus. Till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. Oh, I speak Jesus. 'Cause your name is power. Depression. Oh, I speak Jesus. 'Cause your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life. Lord, break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn for my family. I speak the holy name, Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains. Jesus in the stream. Jesus in the darkness, over the power of the enemy. Shout Jesus from the mountains and Jesus in the streets. Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name. Jesus.
Oh, shout Jesus from Jesus in the street, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy, Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus. Oh.
Behold, I am the Lord thy God. I am the Almighty God. There is no other God higher, stronger, or mightier than I. I am the Lord God of the living. I am not dead. I'm not asleep, but I'm alive forevermore. I am more than able to do what thou hast me to do. For I am the Almighty God. There is nothing too big or nothing too hard for me, saith the Lord. You have not because you ask not. I say unto thee this night, ask of me, and let me show you who I am. I am the Lord God Almighty, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. Can't see how it's going to work out, don't mean it can't work out. God is still the Almighty God that can still work out the impossible situations. Don't give up. Don't quit. Keep praying and keep believing tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Touching Jesus.
Yes.
Is all that really matters. Then your life will never be the same. There is only one way to touch Him. You must believe when you call on His name. Oh, touching Jesus is all that really matters. In your life will never be the
tonight. It's all right to say, Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief. If you got to say that and pray that, it's okay. Amen?
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen. Good to be in the house of the Lord tonight. Can we give Him another hand clap of praise? Come on. Thank God for His presence. Amen. Remember, Bible study Wednesday night, 6:30. Amen. Remember the announcements. Amen. Sister Jennifer, will you dismiss us tonight in prayer?
Thank you.